colors have fled before they ask us to pay the bill, and while we still have a chance, let's face the music and dance. Soon teardrops to shed. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance, dance. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance, dance. Let's face the music and dance. So while there's moonlight and I love you, which is easy to see, but I have to keep guessing how you feel about me. You listen to the words that I speak, but I feel that you listen with your tongue in your cheek. Be sentimental for you, laughing at me, I know. I want to be romantic, but I haven't a chance. You've got a sense of humor, and humor is death to romance. You're laughing at me. Why do you think it's funny when I say that I love you so? You at me.
listen to the band, don't you get a bubble. As you listen to them play, don't you get a glow. If you step out on the floor, you'll forget your troubles. If you go into your dance, you forget your woes. So come get together, let the dance floor feel your leather. Step as lightly as a feather, let yourself go. Come hit the timber, loosen up and start to limber. Can't you hear that hot marimba? Let yourself go. Let yourself go. Relax and let yourself go. Relax, you've got yourself tied up in a knot. The night is cold, but the music's hot. So come, cuddle closer. Don't you dare to answer no, sir. Put your banker, clerk, and grocer. Let yourself go. Let yourself go, relax, and let yourself go, relax. You've got yourself tied up in a knot. The night is cold, but the music's hot, so come on, cuddle closer. Don't you dare to answer no, sir. Put your banker, clerk, and grocer. Let yourself go. Let yourself go. Not worth fighting for. Besides, there's plenty more where he came from. I don't want him, you can have him. I'm giving him the sack, and he can go right back where he came from. I could never make him happy. Better off with you. I'm afraid I never loved him. All I ever wanted to do was run my fingers through his curly locks, mend his underwear and darn his socks, fetch his slippers and remove his shoes, wipe his glasses when he read the news, rub his forehead with a gentle touch, mornings after when he's had too much, kiss him gently when he cuddle near, give him babies, one for every year. So you see, I don't want him, you can have him, you can have him. I don't want him, for he's not the man for me. Him, I don't want him, he's not worth fighting for. Besides, there's plenty more where he came from. I don't want him, you can have him, he isn't my concern, and he can just return where he came from. I would look a trifle silly taking him away from you. That was never my intention. All I ever
to do was close the window while he soundly slept. Raid the icebox where the food is kept. Cook a breakfast that would please him most. Eggs and coffee and some butter toast. Wake him gently with a breakfast tray. After breakfast, clear the things away. Bring the papers, and when they've been read, spend the balance of the day in bed. So you see, I don't want him. You can have him. You can have him. I don't want him, for he's not the man for me.
You go where fashion sits, putting on the Ritz. Different types who wear a day coat, pants with stripes and cutaway coats, perfect fits, putting on the Ritz. Dressed up like a $1 million trooper, trying hard to look like Gary Cooper. Super duper, come let's mix where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts. Putting on the Ritz. Duper, come let's mix where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mix. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz.
get thee behind me, Satan. I want to resist, but the moon is low and I can't say no. Get thee behind me. Get thee behind me, Satan. I mustn't be kissed, but the moon is low and I may let go. Get thee behind me. Someone I'm mad about is waiting in the night for me. Someone that I mustn't see. Satan, get thee behind me. He promised to wait, but I won't appear, and he may come here. Satan, he's at my gate. Get thee behind me. Stay where you are, it's too late.
Come on in here, Alexander's a ragtime band. Come on in here, come on in here. It's the best band in the land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you wanna go to war. That's just the best band. What am, oh, my honey lamb. Come on along, come on along. Let me take you by the hand. Up to the man, up to the man. Who's the leader of the band? And if you care to hear the Swanee River played in a ragtime, come on in here, come on in here. Alexander's a ragtime band. Thank you. man in the land. They can't fool but do 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 do. That's just the bestest band. What am oh my honey lamb? Come on along, come on along. Let me take you by the hand up to the man, up to the man. Who's the leader of the band? And if you care to hear the Swanee River played in cool time. Or if you want to hear the Swanee River playing in ragtime. Come on in here, come on in here, Alexander's ragtime band. Brushing off my tails, I'm dooting up my shirt front, putting in the shirt studs, polishing my nails. I'm stepping out, my dear, to breathe an atmosphere that simply reeks with class. And I trust that you'll excuse my dust when I step on the gas, for I'll be there, putting down my top hat, busting up my white tie, dancing in my tail. I just got an invitation through the mail. Your presence requested this evening. It's formal, a top hat, a white tie, and tail. Nothing now could take the wind out of my sails, because I'm invited to step out this evening with top hat and white tie and tail. I'm putting on my top hat, tying up my white tie, brushing off my tail. I'm dooting up my shirt front, putting in the shirt studs, polishing my nails. I'm stepping out, my dear, to breathe an atmosphere that simply reeks with class. And I trust that you'll excuse my dust when I step on the gas, for I'll be there, putting down my top hat, mussing up my white tie, dancing in my tail. You are
To be colorblind, but I met you and now skies. That semicircle that was always hanging about is not a storm cloud, it's a rainbow. You brought the colors out. Believe me, it's really true. Till I met you, I never knew a setting sun could paint such beautiful skies. I never knew there was such lovely colors. And the big surprise is the red in your cheeks, the gold in your hair, the blue in your eyes.
I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I see. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek, heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek, oh, I'd love to go out fishing in a river or a creek, but it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I'd love to have a mountain and reach its highest peak, but it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Dance with me, I want my arms about you. The charms about you will carry me through to heaven. I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I see. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek, when we're gathering each Monday at the start of the week, when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek, oh, I'm in heaven, yeah, yeah. Thank you, Andy. Thank you all for being here tonight. Thanks for hanging out. Today is a dangerous, dangerous night for me musically because it's going to be a lot of talking. Talking about each one of these songs and where they might come from. And I hope everybody's on board with that. It was your idea. Catherine, you did start. It is starting at 7:30. You're here. You got the right time. Hey, what's up, Tommy? I'm glad you're here. Max Fly Art is one of my best friends in the world, Tommy Hallman. And he was the one that said to me at some point, you know what, Vance, you might want to pay less attention to your feed because people see you looking at the feed. But tonight is a night where I need to look at the feed quite a bit. Because it's a dangerous night to talk a whole lot, and it's also a dangerous night because I know there's going to be a lot of requests coming in, and I don't want to be the land of no because I can't play something. So I'm going to do my best with that, but let's have some fun anyway. This is Icarus by Night, and the idea for this song just came from my love as a kid of Greek mythology. And as I got older and started doing stuff in the music business, you'd hear the... He takes it back, Tom says. I kept thinking of... how so often when we succeed, it comes from a variety of failures. And failure is important. No matter how dramatic the story is, good or bad, in the end, you never know. And that's, I guess I'm saying what this song is about, but that's what I was thinking at the time I wrote it, and it goes like this. I only go up at night when the moon is full and the evening breezes blow. I go only high enough to see the ground below. I only go up at night. That's when no one else can see me being foolish and wishing for one more chance to do it all again. I was so much younger then and blinded by the beauty of the sun. It looked so lovely, I just had to touch it once, then tumbling down into the sea. Now I know, he taught me how to fly, and like any son, I wanted to make good my first impression. But words from the wise were wasted on the foolish and the young. Now I only go up at night. The illusion is complete. No one knows of my survival. And the twilight hours are mine and mine alone. I was so much younger then and blinded by the beauty of the sun. It looked so lovely, I just had to touch it once, then tumbling down into the sea. Now I know Thank you. I was so much younger then, and blinded by the beauty of the sun. It looked so lovely, I just had to touch it once, then tumbling down into the sea. Now I know. Ooh. Stay and see. Somebody wondered where Zombie Patty Cake came from. Tom Holman knows this story. He was there. He filmed it. There's a video out somewhere. I think it's on YouTube somewhere of me. And this young model airplane flyer, Maria. At the time, Maria was probably 14, 15 years old, and she'd come flying with her dad, and she struck up great friendships with all of us, and she's a wonderful model airplane flyer to boot. Sometimes she's on the feed here. I don't know if she's here tonight. But I think it was really hot one day. We were walking around like zombies. And I said to Maria, I said, what would it be like? What do zombies do in their spare time when they're not just being zombies? And we had this idea of these two zombies walking towards each other. Bumping into each other, bumping heads, and then playing patty cake. So we mimed it. And everybody around was cracking up, and we had such a great time with it. And I started fumbling around with this song right there on the field. And then I put it together. This is what I came up with. Once upon a time when we were dead, you know, just wandering around, biting and eating everybody all over town. Not a lot of brain function at the old spinal cord junction. So we amble and we ramble and make the strangest of sounds. With all that tromping and marauding and human smokers bored and other zombie business, you know what zombies surely can get bored. So when two zombies greet each other and bump foreheads, it's no mistake, it's a perfect opportunity for some zombie patty cake. Zombie patty cake. Clap the back of both hands, and the right, then the left, and the wrist, to your friends. You thought your arms might fall off and your elbows might break, but other than that, have yourself a good time. Please, some zombie patty cake. Well, I think I ate the sailor that went to CCC. He tasted kind of salty, well, at least he did to me. And I remember very fondly that baker baking just as fast as he can. I have it on good authority that he's the sweetest old man. Yeah, we have lowered expectations whenever we try to dance, because you're bound to step on somebody's foot and take down their zombie pants. And if zombie pants falling down wasn't the worst mistake, when your leg come clean up with it, it's time for zombie patty cake. Zombie patty cake. Clap the back of both hands, in the right, then the left, and the wrist of your friends. We thought about square dancing, but those rules, for goodness sake, let's do something we can handle. Let's play some zombie patty cake. I'm who does. So if you ever wake up and find yourself dead, and you and your zombie friends are walking around scratching your head, but if you look for entertainment options in which we all can partake, I'll get yourself a zombie partner, play some zombie party cake. Zombie patty cake. Clap the back of both hands, then the right, then the left, then the wrist of your friends. We thought about breakdancing, but that don't seem right. Zombie patty cake. Clap right, left. Don't forget your wrists. Arm wrestling's out of the question. There's just too much at stake, so we go with this option. We play some zombie patty cake. And she and I were just walking, bumping to each other. And then we played. It would be like that, and it was very funny. I see Tom said something about it. He was witness. I'm remembering it the best I can. Is that close to the story, Tom? It's not live, but we can make it so if Maria and you agree. We could do that at some point. I thought it was up, but it was a very funny, very funny time. I don't have an agenda, so I'm just. I'm always intrigued by the impressionistic song. And this song came from, I was driving. Across the Midwest, I was Radio Bob's show in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I was either heading towards that or getting ready to play it, and I was really missing home. And I came home and wrote this. 10,000 skies. That's how I count them. Just keeping time simply won't do. Crazy is this ticket to Tulsa. Crazy is a drink off a wagon. 10,000 skies. Just one more night. 10,001. Braver than walking through fire. Braver than saying goodbye. 10,000 skies. This guitar part with the was as close as I could get to Sean Colvin Steady On. Ooh. And I looked up at some point what 10,000 guys were. I just divide 365 into 10,000. Like 7 years or something like that. Leaving Avon. It was a folk series in a town called Avon. I had played it once and then it was fine, it was great. And I was slated to play it the next year. Three or four months before the gig came up, I got an offer to tour. I don't remember who it was with. So we asked the promoter, who was a minister at a church in this town. We said, like, hey, look, we'd love to get Vance out of this show so he could go take this tour. It might have been a Carlin thing. I don't remember who it was. It might have been a tour of Canada. But it was many months before the season for them started. And this promoter got so angry. He wrote me a letter telling me this is what you're agent is trying to do. You should be affiliated with better people, because I wouldn't expect this from you. To ask a third of a year out to get out of a show, it's just unconscionable. I was pretty angry at this guy. Well, we did get out of the contract. And that happens all the time in the music business, particularly that far out. And it wasn't any reflection on him or what he was doing. He could have booked me later in the season. But his sense as a promoter was beaten up. So I expounded upon the idea of leaving Avon forever, leaving Avon forever, leaving Avon forever, and it's through no choice of mine. I'm leaving Avon forever, leaving Avon forever, I'm leaving Avon forever, and it's through no choice of mine. There's a woman down in Avon, got a husband gunning for me. She sits staring out the window and jumps for the phone when it rings. And the preacher down in Avon wrote an angry letter to me. Said I won't be invited back if a father quoting scripture. I guess he didn't want to waste it. Now that just don't sound like the Jesus he preached about on Sunday. So I'm leaving. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. And it's through no choice of mine. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. And it's no choice of mine. It's a good thing that it's Sunday. It's a good good thing that it's raining. It hollows this departure. The only ones to notice are the widows and the veterans on their porches and verandas, just sitting and rocking, rocking and remembering. And I guess that it's a blessing that they don't come to the railing and ask me where I'm going. I would have to give a reason for leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever, and it's through no choice of mine. So long to the peach trees in the rolling golden meadows on the south side of this town. All the fruit will be indifferent to whether I'm there or not come picking time. Farewell to the children that play hide and seek beneath the clotheslines. Backyard, there's one there with a twinkle in her eye. I swear she might be mine. As I pass by St. Alicia's, all the nuns look very busy, and the only one to notice is a cross upon her forehead. And my little mermaid. It's a busted out Marianne. And if west is my direction, it's as good a way as any for leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever, and it's no choice of mine. I'm leaving Avon forever, and I'm leaving Avon forever. Garth. Leaving Avon forever, and it's through no choice of mine. I'm leaving Avon forever. Hey, yeah, yeah. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm leaving Avon forever. I'm going to Revlon instead. It's the better hair products, and their skin stuff is darker. I'm leaving Avon forever, and it's through no choice of mine.
No, Katie, it wasn't Avon, Connecticut. It was Avon, Massachusetts. Yeah, I don't know what that guy is doing now. He's preaching somewhere, I'm sure. I couldn't remember to. And my bags won't make me weary, because it isn't very heavy. And it's something or other. It's a $10 pawn shop legacy. It's a blushing bride sunset, so I head for that horizon. Na, 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 na. I'm leaving Avon forever. Yeah. So, yeah, I had to go there because Maybelline. Yeah, there's an Avon, Mass. Yeah. Not many people know there's an Avon, Mass. Yep. That's where it was. And, you know, I have... Yeah. You, at some point or another, you get old enough, you're going to piss somebody off. a concert stream of puns are us. Very, very funny. Let me do this. Avon, Mass is south of Boston. I'll get to the pound of prevention, Scott. This is for Maria. It's her birthday. Maria of Maria of My and Michael. Maria Pinardo. Happy birthday, love. We'll play a mini set for you. I did not get any Charlie Pride together tonight, John. And that's a real loss because he was a trendsetter. As far as that goes at this point. Okay, Unfamiliar Moon. I've that's on the list to tell the story of too. This is a cover. This is a Randy Newman tune. This goes to both of my Marias, my goddaughter, and this Maria too. You look like a princess on the night that we met. With your hair piled up high, I will never forget. I'm drunk right now, baby, but I have to be. I can never tell you what you mean to me. I love you, and I love you the first time I saw you. And I always will love you, Maria. I love you the first time I saw you. And I always will love you, Maria. The song that the trees sing when the wind blows. You're a flower, you're a river, you're a rainbow. Maybe I'm crazy, but I guess you know. I'm weak and I'm lazy, and I hurt you so. And I don't listen to a word you say. When you're in trouble, girl, I just turn away. And I love you, and I love you the first time I saw you. And I always will love you, Maria. I love you the first time I saw you, and I always will love you, Marie. And to keep that house happy. It's from Michael and Maria. This is Hitman. And the story behind this, I was staying in a hotel between two gigs, two New York upper state gigs. And it was springtime. Oh, Waiting for Gilligan. Yeah, I'll tell a story about that when I get the chance. So I was staying in upstate New York, and I'd taken this little motel. It was a ground level thing, out on a kind of busy street. I'd say about an hour and a half from New York City, somewhere. I don't even remember the town. Hey, Scott Williamson, it's nice to see you too, by the way. And I had the door open and I was writing. And this car drove slowly past with a big dark sedan. It's sort of an older guy sitting in it. And he wasn't looking at me, he was looking at something else at the hotel. And then he sped off. I wonder what he was casing. I wonder what he was looking at. Because he's clearly driving by slowly enough to see what was up. So I wrote this song. Just made up the story. I'll be 83 in August. I probably shouldn't drive at night. Add to that this rain-slick road, even in the cracked headlight, it's clearly just a friend of the die. Sorry I'm adding to you. Here's a roll of $100 bills. Pretty certain that'll do. 80 years will give you wrinkles. Wrinkles never hide the eyes. Eyes on the dead shore give away, even to the best of skies. Kid, you got the kind of face, like I can tell you anything. It's been a long time between confessions, the peace that might bring. A good hitman learns how the powder burns. Pull the trigger in a glove, take another name forever. Take you for what you love. I've been coaching Little League. I know all the children's names. There's nothing like my tulip garden or my toy electric planes. Then they came to Inglewood shoot out. We all scattered with the wind like petals from a late spring dogwood, never to be seen again. That was back in 67. You think I'd settle far away? Keep a close eye on this today. This is where my Yankees play. I kid you got that kind of face, like I could tell you anything. It's been a long time between confessions, the peace that might bring. A good hitman learns to hide the powder burns. Pull the trigger in a glove, take another name forever. Take you to one you love. Someone's always got an axe to grind. Some kid I've never seen before. Some son of a job I had done. Some kid out to even the score. Maybe I'm a kitchen whisper. When his mama's in her gin. Maybe number one on his hit list. My good fortune running thin. You seem to be a nice young fellow. And I know it's getting late. No need to trouble 911. Memorize your license plate. Kid, you got the kind of face, I can tell you anything. It's been a long time between confessions and the peace that might bring. A good hitman learns to hide the powder burns and pull a trigger in a glove. I'll take another name forever. Take you the one you love. I like you. Glad you like that line, son of a job I done, Drew. One of the things about that song when I was recording it, a little front story, I got a couple good versions of it. I played it live. I would play it live and sing it down, and And the yodel, the whoa, when I got to that part, it sounded like I'm bragging, but it was so clean. Each time I did it, it sounded like an edit. So I would hit it. I'd miss a couple once in a while. I'd go like, oh, let's go back and take another version and get that. But I hit a bunch of them. Whoa. And the problem with hitting them that clean and making them sound like an edit is that they sound like an edit. So we tried to smooth them out. We tried to make them dirty, but it was guitar and vocal at the same time. So we couldn't do much. So we had to record it like... That was back in 67. Think I'd sit them far away. I keep a close eye on this. And then I'd go... And go ahead and go back and go, whoa, or I'd stagger it, whoa, I had to do something greasier. So that's how I had to attack that song. That's what happened to that in the studio. So happy birthday, Maria. Hi, Michael. Happy birthday to you guys. Since it's a birthday, if you've got other things you'd like to hear, let me know and I'll play it. Somebody asked me for... let's see, I'm scrolling back. Thank you, Jeanette. Thank you so much for your vote of confidence. I'm singing pretty well tonight. I had a nap. I didn't sleep that well last night. I pissed somebody off over on Facebook. I put a post up about somebody glibly walked by. A neighbor walked by with no mask. With her neighbor with no mask and shot over their shoulder. Can you imagine that Charlie Baker has decided that there's not going to be any live music? Can you deal with that? And I was like, yeah, I've been dealing with that all summer. Why? So I posted the interchange on Facebook without mentioning any names, and they saw it, and they're mad, and they unfriended me. So I didn't get a lot of sleep on that last night. But then I decided, you know what? There comes a time when people draw these battle lines. Sometimes you gotta be ready to do a little battle, and I'm trying to be Judeo-Buddhist Christian about a bunch of stuff, but sometimes you just have to put your foot down and stand up for what you stand for, and I don't know if it'll make the concurrent viewers count go down here. I hope not, but I'm gonna play a brand new song that I wrote this afternoon. It's called Brand New Flag. And I'm doing a lot of mileage nowadays. I'm doing a lot of running, very slowly. Anyone who's ever run with me knows that I run slowly. Ask Peter Mulvey. We go running when we're at festivals together, and people think his name is Wade Up. So this is a song that I wrote this afternoon. And it kind of speaks for itself. Yeah, I'm sorry she reacted that way too, Teresa. It was it's kind of a drag. And I apologized offline, and she said, you know, and she unfriended me, and I said, well, you know, you didn't have to unfriend me. She said, yeah, your Facebook is for your business, and mine is for private friend conversations, and we have different needs, so it's just as well. And I'm like, okay. Thank you, Penny, 25 pounds. That's what I've lost at this point. And I get to listen to a lot of great music thanks to these little ear things that I got in my phone. If I don't get the melody to this, it's because I don't remember what it is. You got a brand new flag. You took the red, white, and blue. Change around all the colors. Made it me against you. Such a creative endeavor. With its one blue stripe. Straight across smack dab middle. of the black and the white. I remember the old one you used to proudly fly. We would stand underneath it, disagree over beers on the 4th of July. And now you wave you a new one. I used to love this town until you choose a line of blue over black and brown. Well, that's quite the new flag. You kept the stripes of white. You got your 50 white stars. You got that part right. Was there a textile failure? Or did you just lose track? Did you notice the rest of your brand new flag is mostly black? It ain't lost on me. Another bloodstained rag. It ain't nothing new. I got plenty to do. Fixing the original red, white, and blue. It ain't nothing new. Now I'm dealing with you and your brand new flag. It's a brand new flag. You took your wet, white, and blue. Change around all your colors. Made it me against you. So that's as close as I got to getting that done tonight, and thank you for letting me premiere it. I hope I haven't offended anybody whose politics are you know me. I don't hit the political thing hard here. I hit it personal. I don't sing big ass political songs, but yeah, your John Prine's tune. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you like it, Matt. Thank you so much. Let's see. Thank you for witnessing it. You know, Cheryl Wheeler says, there are nights where your job is to take care of the audience. That's our job. That's our job as singer-songwriter. We take care of the audience. But there's nights where the audience takes care of you. And I hope you don't mind. This is one of those. I appreciate that. Appreciate you being here. Let me do a little commercial. Tonight's 10 to 15% goes to the Tufts Wildlife Clinic at the Cummings Veterinary Medical Center out in Grafton, Massachusetts. You can't imagine all the things that they do. John, you're great. Woohoo! And I'm a right-leaning libertarian. Thank you, John, for witnessing and saying what you're about Yeah, this black flag, a black American flag is tripping me out. So I decided to own it. I said, most of that flag is black. So take that. Thank you, David. David Allen, wonderful songwriter. I coach him a bit, and he is fine on his own route, so that he's here. The Cummins Veterinary Medical Center is they're the place where when Deborah finds an injured bird or injured chipmunk, or she drove out there with a chipmunk, or either that or the neighbors, they drove out there with a chipmunk. Sometimes they just have to put them down. Love you too, John. And that's what people have to do. They drive out there with birds and everything else, and the place doesn't want you to drive out there with all these animals all the time, but that is what part of what they're about, and that's how we got to know them. But they are, they rehab all kinds of animals, and they are to the small animal population what last week's mass Audubon is in a large scale to our environment. So they are something else. 10 to 15% goes out to them. I don't know why I'm holding this up. It's just my notes. You can't really see that. So that's where that goes to. And so thank you for taking care of that. And thank you for taking care of me and help me pay a little bit of my mortgage. Tomorrow I go back in for I don't know what they're going to do with this tooth, but I got to pay for that. So whatever you decide to do is great. Thank you so much. And look, if you got nothing, I got it. But if you know how this goes, this is we're going to be here a while until everybody gets a needle in the damage done. Till we get inoculated. So I'm going to keep doing this. And there, that's what we're doing. I'm going to do this till we... yes, they do, Deb. They do a great job with animal rescue and treatment. In fact, we were watching a lecture the other night. They were talking about local sharks and some of the things they do in freeing one shark up from a fishing line. And it's amazing stuff. What's the song that Deborah sings back up on live sometimes? Sometimes it's sometimes she sings on Gentle Arms of Eden, the Dave Carter song, or on Richard Thompson's Dimming of the Day. That's when we have it. So I'm glad you guys like the flag song. Let's go after one that Unfamiliar Moon. Unfamiliar Moon comes from a friend of mine some years ago. Was in a marriage, and it started to come about that her marriage was failing. And in the failing of that marriage, there were some day-to-day things that had to happen. And I saw her somewhere, and I said, how's the whole thing going? And she said, I'm away for the weekend because he's moving his stuff out. And then a couple weeks later, I saw this person at another gig, and I said, so how did that go? And she said, it was to be honest, it was very difficult. That day after I saw you at the show, I went home. And it was after midnight. And I knew the place was mine. It would be a couple rooms worth that was empty. And she said, I just dreaded it, no matter how much the thing needed to end. Each step to the front door was, each one got more and more difficult. And I looked up, and even the moon didn't look right. And I was like, oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. So that's where I got the title and those important lyrics. And this is what I came up with. Unfamiliar moon. Stars are out of place. Everything is new. Everything has changed. like a baby child just has to cry when she sees it for the first time and she don't understand. Now then there's no you, everything is new like this unfamiliar moon. That can't be our song. Those are the words I know. The melody is all wrong, but the DJ says that's how it goes. Like a child has to learn on his own. You get too close to a bird and she'll be gone. Now then there's no you, everything is new like unfamiliar moon. Can't be my house. How can this be home? I don't recognize it anymore. Each step to the front door is higher than I've known. It's like climbing up a mountain, cause now I climb alone. Now then there's no you, everything is new like this unfamiliar moon. Now then there's no you, everything is new like this unfamiliar moon. Oh, thank you, Bill. That's a really nice comment. Thank you so much. Yeah, it's a big ass song, as it were. Yeah, thanks so much. Yeah, I'm glad you dug it. Let me see if I could chase. Yeah, it's a heartbreaker, Deb. Thanks for recognizing that. Let me see if I can get through Waiting for Gilligan. The story behind Waiting for Gilligan. Waiting for Gilligan comes from a Snickers commercial. And it was a Snickers commercial where there's... It's clearly an 85-year-old Ginger or Marianne. I can't remember who it was. But she's looking out from a balcony of a lighthouse or a
lakeside property. Or I don't know what it was. And you hear playing in the background, desert isle. And she looks out at the water and says, he's coming back. I know he is. And she's like 85 years old. And the guy in the background says, got a long wait? Have a Snickers bar. I watch the waves going out like some eternal chore. I understand the habit as they break upon the shore. Keep this lonely vigil so my heart won't break no more. I'm waiting for Gilligan. Days turn to weeks, and the weeks turn into years. And there's some that say I'm crazy when they see me sitting here. Tell all who would commit me, I know what commitment is. I'm waiting for Gilligan. The short weave has been broken down for years, but I'm listening with much more than just my ears. Waiting for Gilligan. Waiting. Waiting for Gilligan. Captains, kids, and captains now, and most have come and gone on motorboats and sailing ships with cargoes of their own. But my fingers crossed with every ship that makes the trip back home. I'm waiting for Gilligan. Practice makes a prophet. Well, I think I've got it down. After 30 years of waiting for a man who's not around. Faith and hope were made of gold, and I would wear that crown. Cause I'm waiting for Gilligan. To look at me, the years may seem unkind, but there's just enough of me left not to mind. Waiting, waiting for Gilligan. Waiting, waiting. My passion any more than some of you. When I lay down, I dream about a love I know that's true. I know folks who laid side by side for years and never knew that they were stranded. Now I want you to tell me, somebody tell me, who's on an island now? He's out there somewhere, and if he don't come home to me, then I'll go out to meet him when they bury me at sea. Then we will be together and I'll no longer be waiting for Gilligan. You tell Ginger, Mrs. Howe, and Mary Ann, I'll always burn the candle for my man. Waiting, waiting, waiting.
Ooh, I haven't played that in a while. That's the story behind that. I know, it's silly and serious at the same time. That's what do you do with that, right? thank you for that. I'm going to play this. Oh, Lynn really wanted to know about that. Dawn, huh? She wanted to know that. Cool, man. This is a new one. This is I Hope He's the One This Time. And it comes from a friend of mine, student that I saw her date. And she went online and found a guy that she thought was cool. She was with a man that wouldn't let her do stuff. Just so she left that relationship, and that was her second marriage, as it was anyway. And then let me do this ballad, Scott. Then I'll do Pound of Prevention and talk about that. And then she landed this other musician, and she started seeing him for a while, and he was hooked up with somebody else already. And so then she went back online and found another guy, and she's just the dearest character, and I've just wished her the best, because she seems to not flail, but just like strike out from time to time. And she's a student, and she says, "Well, I hope this is the one." And I was like, so that's where this comes from. I hope he's the one this time, and he sees you as a mystery. He doesn't mind a little history, and understands that goodness doesn't spring from nowhere. I hope he's the one this time. I pray to God that he's an A1 listener. Fingers crossed that he's a kiss-ass kisser. And he holds your hand for no good reason. Who would hold against you all you meant to someone else? What fool leave you broken like the last one always does? I hope he's the one this time. May your party go uninterrupted as your heart gets reconstructed and you untie the pretty bows of compromise. Cue up the band, dry your eyes. Maybe he's the one. I hope he's the one. I hope he's the one this time. More I play that song, the more I love it. So yeah, I'm glad you dig it. I'm glad you think it's cool. I like that one too, Linda. This song is thievery. I was trying to do Lee, I already told the story about Icarus by Night. You missed it. This is Pound of Prevention. And I stole this idea. There's a song by Joan Armatrading called Opportunity that Bobby McFerrin also covers a cappella. It's about a robbery gone wrong. And I fell in love with it years ago. But rather than do that song, I decided I might write my own robbery song. And this was long before Me Too, and that's not a warning, it's the fact that there's a woman in this song that's a protagonist. And I'm proud of myself for being even halfway forward thinking. But it's told from the point of view of this guy, and he says, there I was, working at the window, turning pennies and paychecks into savings and loans. Reach for the ceiling, she said, the gun's quite loaded. Fill the bag up with big bills and I'll be gone. Caught her eyes underneath the bandana. Wild as fire, that's when I fell in love. Everybody lay down, count to 100. Except for you, boy, cause I'm taking you hostage. What's that I feel? Between my shoulder blades, like ice cold steel. She explained it was a pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. Pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. Do as I tell you, you'll be alright. Don't try nothing funny, I'll let you stay alive. A woman like you, you seem so bright. Why you wanna lead a life of crime, babe? I tried it your way, but I got burned. I thought I had a job and a good man, but I had a lot to learn. Found out quickly the real road to success. Since social security is all wrapped up in this here. What's that I feel? Between my shoulder blades like ice cold steel. She explained it was a pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. Pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. Hot water Chevy, she worked so fast, I swear to God she did it with just one hand. Blue lights flashing in the rearview mirror, we took the back roads and we lost the man. Deserted rest stop somewhere on the highway, she taped my ankles and then tied my hands. Gunned the motor, blew me a kiss, sped off into the sunset, never to be seen again. I finally got myself untied, yes I did. Sat pulled up right, by my side was a bankroll of $1,000 bills on the ground. She stole my heart, but she left me here with this pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. Pound of prevention. 16 ounces of cure for this hard world. me with a pound of the chum. Don't you be right. That's the story in that song. I hope your son is there with a mask, Kathleen. Mm-hmm, that's all I'm saying. Just showing up. Awesome. What else do I have? What else do I have here? Wow, yeah. Some people have asked me where I got Eliza Jane from. That's a story unto itself. On a whim one time, I was playing the Tin Angel in Philly. I wasn't a whim playing there, but on a whim to travel there, I decided to take the train. Because the train was about two blocks away from the club, and I figured I could take the train down earlier in the day and then finish up at the club and get on kind of like a midnight train to Georgia. There was something that left Philly at 1:30 in the morning and got home at 7. All right, I'll do Pablo's Lights next. And in this train station, at 1:30 in the morning, there were these women, a whole clatch of them, I'd say early 20s, post-teen, early 20s. And they were black, except for one. She was white with blonde hair. And each one of them had at least one child. And this one woman, the white one, had a very golden child with golden hair, as you might imagine. Gregor Mendel would make sure that that's what happened in a way. And they were wagging their heads and talking and, you know, talking as black women might. I don't know, that's a characterization, but that's just how it was. Well, these people taking the train coming back, and the white woman was talking just as black as the rest of them. And I wondered what that story was. And that happens with a lot of my songwriting. So here's Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza Jane, of all the things your daddy said, and some of them were so cruel, one of them was true. He said we wouldn't last because it was so hard. Oh, Eliza Jane, say so long to your trust fund as you slammed the door and swore you'd never see them again. Narrow-minded, white, and unenlightened's what you said. Now you and your pride live on the east side in a furnished fourth-floor room, and the rent is due. Oh, Eliza Jane, it was you and I holding hands, black and white and looking like a Unitarian Christmas card. It loses all its luster long before the holidays because it's been so hard. Oh, Eliza Jane, what hair you didn't cut or perm you had braided back, hoping your predetermined genetic situation might be mistaken for being black. Oh, Eliza Jane. Your friends from private school thought it was the coolest thing. My friends reminded me that no amount of cream in my coffee would turn it to a glass of milk. Now sisters roll their eyes and suck their teeth, and rednecks shake their heads in total disbelief at us. Oh, Eliza Jane, it was you and I, holding hands black and white and looking like a Unitarian Christmas card that's prematurely torn and tossed beneath the tree because it's been so hard. Eliza Jane, one night I heard you pray this color crazy world to go away. But it's too late, the canvas is painted on, all the pretty colors gone, and there's nothing left to say. So I left you with two children we thought would fix it all, with eyes like yours and hair like mine. Oh, Eliza Jane, it was you and I holding hands, black and white, and looking like a Unitarian Christmas car. It's prematurely torn and tossed beneath a tree because it's been so hard. Wow, I've forgotten how much I love playing that thing. That's great. People are asking about Pablo's lights. The thesis behind Pablo's lights was stealing the ideas of escape from the movie A Kiss of the Spider Woman with William Hurt and God, I played a later Gomez Adams. What's his name? William Hurt. Somebody help me out here. Well, William Hurt was sent in to extract information from this revolutionary by befriending him in a homosexual relationship. One taught one about dignity and the other one taught the other about how to escape. Raul Julia, yes, thank you. Yes. So this is taken from that and taken from my childhood a bit. Corporal punishment and alcohol and schizophrenia were hallmarks of my bringing up as a kid. I know it makes my brother feel itchy when he hears it. But this is the story. Just a man with a boat that I saw in a picture long ago. Just a magazine ad. An old wooden ship right lit at the stern. And he smiled as he waved at me over his shoulder. Sing, come sail with me, welcome. memory. Somewhere to be where you're too young to run, where each angry word would drown in the sound of the sea. And we'd laugh and toll the line of a candy cane anchor. I was one of his black and blue children, fishing for angels at sea. It was Pablo's lights that I dream of by the riverside, that I see as the horizon folds up for the day. I've got the soul of the mainland on my AM dial, but oh, what a welcome sign. See Pablo's lights, and I'd wait for him. I could hear his diesel humming, and we'd sing along, and together we'd sound like a symphony that would take me far away from the bruises of the shoreline, where I no longer hear the sound of fighting ringing inside my head. It's Pablo's lights that I dream of by the riverside, that I see as the horizon folds up for the day. I've got the soul of the mainland on my AM dial. Oh, what a welcome sight to see Pablo's lights. Let them shine. It won't hurt so bad for so long as time. Long as they shine, and I can see them burning bright. Now I hear speed. Now I steal these words and these phrases from my life. I rearrange them some, and they still cut like a knife. But I'll make peace with them and silence forever the slap of yesterday. Until then, I'll go off somewhere inside my head. It's Pablo's lights that I dream of by the riverside, that I see as the horizon folds up for the day. I've got the soul of the mainland on my AM dial. Oh, what a welcome sign. What a welcome sight. See Pablo's light. Let them shine. Here's Pablo's light. Thanks so much for asking for that. And gosh, just ran out the. It's ran its course tonight. Thank you guys. you are the sweetest bunch of people, honest to God. Let me play one more thing, and let me figure out what that's gonna be. There's a commercial. Tufts Wildlife Center is getting money from this tonight. And, gosh, I appreciate you guys. I want to give a shout out to, I think the folks at the Hastings dojo. There's a Japanese school of Japanese martial arts in England that I think picked this up later, and they watch it later, and they always comment so nicely. And I'm not big on going on to YouTube and answering the comments. Maybe I should be better at that. But I just want to make sure those folks get a shout out when they roll this back. Nothing for you. Yeah, we're getting to the no part of the show, Bane. I couldn't play Nothing for You if I had to. Let's see. Here I am scrolling, and let me just say, next week is it's the holiday show. I'm gonna do some holiday stuff. I'm gonna do tunes that you don't usually hear holiday-wise, and my stuff, but I think I'll just, there's a little commercial. I think I'll do some holiday tunes, tunes that have the holidays in them. Yeah, if for you Jewish folks, I'll do my poor version of Sivi Vov, although Hanukkah is, I think, just about done, or has been done. I'm not sure. I Have Always Loved You. Don't have that either, Drew. Scene of the Crime, I don't play that either. Story without the song is okay too. You just want me to tell stories, Maria? You're so funny. I'm so glad you dug the commentary tonight. I like I said, I was frightened of it. I just didn't, you know, I like trying to keep it a show. I like making it so you guys, you folks, I should say, are inundated with my musical me. And I chat, I try to chat just enough to not... just enough to keep it exciting. A room somewhere. Yeah, let's go out with that. I called my buddy David today. His girlfriend gave me a shout, too, saying, like, hey, what's up? From New York. I guess I can I out them? He's dating Catherine Irby from Law and Order. And she's a great woman. She called me up earlier. I don't know if she's listening or not. Katie, if you're listening, I love you too. Let me leave with David Goldfinger's A Room Somewhere. That he was I can tell a little story about this song. David was really in a very sort of Tom Waits kind of mood, kind of vibe when he was writing this. And he really wanted to make point of detail. He really wanted to write details into songs. And this song is such a success, detail-wise. Some people may call it a list song, but he's so successful at it. And it goes like this. Thumbing through the shoebox letters and photographs, knowing it's too late to cash in on these rain checks on expired passion. So I sit right here and bruise myself on souvenirs, wondering if this junk I save will follow me to my grave or to a room somewhere full of all the things I'd ever lost, all the things that I've forgotten, every venture misbegotten that cannot be redeemed, all my broken dreams and you. Thinking back on moments I shrugged aside, all the days I let slip past as if I could fix the hourglass. There's a castle in the air falling into disrepair, and
iron will that's gone to rust. Neglected and collecting dust in a room somewhere full of all the things I'd ever lost. All the things that I've forgotten, every venture misbegotten that cannot be redeemed. All my broken dreams and you. Knick-knack, bric-a-brac, odds and ends. A stopwatch, a spyglass, a jackknife, a backstage pass. My sense of equilibrium, all the arguments I thought I'd won, are standing side by side near worn-out coats and alibis in a room somewhere. Full of all the things I'd ever lost, all the things that I've forgotten, every venture misbegotten that cannot be redeemed, all my broken dreams and you. Thank you so much, you folks. If you're sticking around, let me read some mail. I got a bunch of mail. I got a bunch of really fun mail from people. Did I read this last time? Oh, this goes back a ways. Yeah, that's it. Lisa Ruggiero, thank you so much. For the card, she came up with two local thank you guys. Oh, I see the thank yous here. Let me put up another commercial real quick here. There you go. As I'm talking about giving to the Tufts Wildlife Clinic, part of the Cummings Veterinary Medical Center. Lisa Ruggiero sends me something about the Newhouse Wildlife Rescue, P.O. Box. It's in Chelmsford, Massachusetts. And there's a Clean River Rescue in Methuen, Mass. Well, maybe I need to look into these as places to donate. She says both charities have heavy presence on Facebook. And she says, thank you for uplifting our spirits with your stories and your songs. Well, you got the stories part tonight. And look at this nice card she sent me. Gingerbread Inn and Cafe. Isn't that adorable? Isn't that nice? Thank you so much, Lisa. Happy holidays to you and your family. That's a nice thing. This is from Clarissa. And oh, come let us adore him. Christ is born. Have wishing you and your family a Merry Christmas and a fabulous year ahead. Thank you so much, Clarissa. Look at them, the you know, Mary and Joseph and the wise men and the everybody. Nobody has eyes, though. Can nobody see? It's lovely and artistic, but come let us adore him. But Jesus' line, they're going like, well, y'all can't see me, so what the hell? See, nobody got eyes. But thank you for that. That's lovely. I'm just being silly and blasphemous. Bill Bosch has such a way with words. My good friend always says, never wish your days away. But maybe we should drop 2020 onto a Viking barge, set it on fire, and send it off the end of the world. Here's the 2021. Amen, Bill Bosch, and your family, Jeanette, and the Lennox, and all those people out there. Warm wishes.
Wish somebody some damn warm wishes with a picture of snow. What the hell? Who wishes somebody warm wishes with a picture of snow? What? Bill, the Boshes, I love them. I played one of the best weddings of my entire career. One of the best gigs of my entire career was for their daughter and son-in-law, and it was great. Have a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. We enjoy your pajama party concerts. This is Mitch and Linda Riznick. And happy holidays. Look at that. Look at that pretty card. Got lots of green on it and stuff. That's pretty as hell. Look at that. Snowflakes and everything. And Linda says, my husband and I have been tuning into your pajama parties since every Monday since sometime. And she saw me originally at a Success for Your Songs online program. And she's been in tuning in since. She's been doing voice, piano, and composition. She has 33 years of teaching music in the classroom. And now she's getting back into writing herself. And that's great. So, yeah, I'll be in touch with you, Linda, and give you some inspiration and a shove. Thanks for your inspiration, your flow of songs, creativity, humor, and uplifting warmth. Oh, you're so nice. You need to shut up. Make people want to continue visiting you. And this is the inside of the thing of the... Look at that. She printed that out with the thing. Is it like a trumpet sitting on the piano? Ain't nobody using it. In my neighborhood, you leave that there, somebody gonna steal it. Uh-huh. That's it. Amber, I did not get to talk about what you gave me a couple weeks ago. And this was a story about the... or did you? Did I talk about the Hall Bulldog? The Hall Bulldog is a plane made by the same people that made the fat little racing plane, the GB. But this was the Robert Hall helped design the GB, and he also designed this Hall Bulldog, which is a portly thing. Looks like a fighting airplane, but it's actually a racer. And at that point in time in history, racing planes... privately made racing planes were faster than the ones that were made by the Army. It was the Army Air Corps then. It was not the Air Force. And the Army Air Force was like, what's going on here? And that's because private ventures are badass. That's what they are. They're just, it was just a very cool thing. Here's the picture of Santa Claus not standing up in the yard. I think it's from Bonnie Hall Diamond. Look at that. There it is. Santa Claus. Santa Claus couldn't stand up. His ass is all knocked over. Check him out. Yeah. Look at that. Yeah. So, and then there's scattered photos here that have nothing to do with saying anything to you people. That's about the mail. And if you have any questions about stuff, I'm here for a little bit. Yeah, why not? Where am I going to go? Where are you going to go other than to bed? Get up, put your headset on, and get back to work. Some of you, those of you who have to go out to work, blessings to you. Lisa Jeanette showed up. Hi, honey bunny. You were working while listening. That's so cool. Yeah, great. Thank you so much for spending double time with me. Lisa Jeanette, this was not... This was not her idea, this chatty version of my show, but she comes up with a lot of the ideas for my shows. And she's a fine singer-songwriter in her own right. She has a single out called Mrs. Claus. And let's just say Mrs. Claus is angry at the world. You guys should check it out. Check out Mrs. Claus, because I'm on it. And but that's not because it's just a great song. And she presented it to me. She's also a coaching client. She presented it to me, and I said, I need to sing on that too. She says, can we make that happen? So we made it happen. And so check out Lisa Jeanette's Mrs. Claus, and let me know what you think. You can go to her, Lisa Jeanette, you can Google her and find her website and stuff. And do I have any instrumental only tracks? No. I'm a fair guitarist for what I do. But I just don't think anybody wants to listen to me doing what I do instrumentally. And I could hire a bunch of people to do that, but I end up writing lyrics for stuff, I suppose. Oh, you guys have, some of you have heard Mrs. Claus, then. Yay, Yippee Skippy. That is so fabulous that you, some of you are onto it. Turn the other one onto it. Somebody asked what the a boy on a train, another friend of mine, who has always, she was dating, and then not dating, and she met a boy on the train, and she met him on the train, and they became friends and hooked up eventually. I don't know what happened with that in the long run, but what the song ended up being was like, oh, that, how sweet is that? We were talking, she said, met a boy on the train, and I said, that sounds like a great idea for a song, and I twisted it. I take people's ideas, and I twist them, and I use them, so I hope you're not mad about that. But yeah, that's where Boy on the Train comes from. Just me and the guitar. I'm not enough of a guitarist to just do a me and guitar anything, Kathleen. But thank you for axing, as we used to say as kids in my neighborhood. Any other questions? We got 78 people still left here. So nice of y'all to hang out. I'm trying to say folks rather than guys. I'm trying to be... have some equanimity in that. This was so much fun tonight. It flew by. When I run my mouth, yeah, acapella is cool. But somebody's just looking for just guitar. Remember your song about the plane that would not land? I've got a plane. I've got a plane. That's off of Unfamiliar Moon, Scott. And I couldn't play that now if I had to. I couldn't remember it to save my life. Oh, Kathleen, there are so many people who play solo guitar so much better. I have students that play me under the table when it comes to setting up a solo guitar thing. Linda, yes, I play. I do songwriting, guitar, vocals, and the combination. I kind of do it all. Look two things down. David Allen is one of my coaching clients. Lisa Jeanette is a coaching client. Who else is here? I don't know if Penny is, Penny and Tony are around. Sometimes they're here. There's a whole mess of them. Scott, I haven't played that in so long. I'll look into it. It's kind of a simple ass country ass waltz. So I'll look into that again. Teresa, it was a blast. Thank you for being here tonight. Yeah, it was, Kathleen, the one bad thing about that bag you sent me, Kathleen, is that I can't use it nowhere. It's still sitting here. It's still sitting here on my table. I ain't got no place to take my bag, my man bag. I just want to put stuff in my man bag. Even if I'd love, if I could have like 3 or 4 hours of being gay, I'd just put my man bag on and go out. Hey, but I, you know, and I don't have to be, just make it. I have no place to take my man bag. I was thinking of putting model airplane research stuff in it. Maybe I'll do that with it. But well, you guys take such monster care of me. I don't even know what to think. Thank you, Lisa Jeanette. I am a good coach. I'm a great coach. I'm very affirming. I got skills. I got skills. They've had to be. You know, kind of readapted for the web and such, but yeah, it's I do an hour, and I'm around $75 for the hour, and everybody knows that I coach with, I always go over an hour. Actually, the lessons are supposed to be 45 minutes, because that's kind of industry standard. Nobody sits with anybody for an hour, but I do an hour, and then some, and that's what I do. Some people I'm monthly, some people I'm weekly. Some people come to me out of the blue. Chris LaFancher, amazing singer-songwriter, came to me with a song last week, and I hadn't seen from or heard from Chris in 3 years. And David Allen is getting his singing chops together and writing chops. We have a ball.
And thank you, David, for your vote of confidence. That's cool. So, yeah, get in touch with me if you feel like getting on a schedule. And, of course, if your money is skinny and you're struggling, we can go very infrequently or even trim down from the 75. But that's generally I start at 75 and do it like that. Teresa, thank you for hanging. It means the beans that you were here. Andy, thanks for being here. It was Ottaware. Ottaware, thank you for sticking around. Sign off with a little Vance guitar. Why do I do anything you say, Bill? You're not the boss of me. Vance guitar. Do a new age album. It would be nice. Add some of the whale sounds. It's a rain stick. Love you, Cousin Don. I have so many questions for you, Cousin Don. We need to FaceTime sometime. I'm wondering if you're still mad at me. Obviously, you're not mad at me for a question I asked you when you were driving me to the airport many years ago. Sorry. Namye o renge ko, namye o renge ko, wa wa. Some instruments I can play as well. I got some harmonicas in here. Instruments in there, but now I can't find them. How's the teeth doing? I go in for a temporary crown tomorrow. That's why I keep hitting this thing here. That's why I keep doing this. I keep doing this. I keep doing that. That's how my teeth are doing. Oh, Karen. Oh, Chuck, that's the nicest thing. Walk slowly with me. of twisting in the air, ball catching, and landing like you never left the ground. Now there's no legs to navigate these stairs. Stand behind me, kindly lift me, going up and going down. Walk slowly with me. Our first night, so uncertain, you and I. We weren't ready until you looked up at the lights of an airplane. You tracked it clear across the sky till it disappeared, blinking behind the Jurgensen's house. I know where you are. Put a good word in for me. Where will I go? When I'm done, we'll have to see. I will find you. Not even God can stop me. Yes, that's your ball. In the corner by the chair, with my best arm, I'll throw it over there for a good boy. Almost home now. Walk slowly. With me.